If you are visiting our channel for the first time, please subscribe first to get the basic and advanced maths concepts.
Hello everyone. Today we will learn that how you can find the focus, vertex and directrix of the shifted parabola that is not having the vertex at 0, 0. So in such a situation, how you can find the focus, vertex. Today I will teach you a very easy method to find the focus, vertex and directrix of the equation as given in the example number 1. So first of all, we will start with the vertex. Now it is clear that the vertex of this equation is not 0, 0. Vertex of the equation will be 0 only if in the case you have the equation in this form. In this form, you will have the vertex 0, 0, because here there is nothing add or subtract from x and y. But when you came across the equations like this, where something is addition, there is something is adding or subtracting from x and y, then we cannot say that the vertex is 0. Now by just looking at this equation, you can find the vertex quickly without solving, as its vertex will be shifted one, and it all depends on this value and this value. Now x value is shifted to the right one unit. So it means its x value will be 1, and its y value is shifted downward 2 units, because when you have the positive sign here, it means it is shifted downward, and if it is negative, it is shifted upward. So it means it is shifted downward and it is shifted by using this, it means it is shifted on the right side. So x is 1 and y is minus 2. So this is the vertex of the given parabola. So we have got the vertex. Next thing is, we have to analyze the position of the parabola, that on which axis it will lie. So we'll analyze how. Let's by using the given equation. In the question, we have x minus 1 whole square equals to 8 into y plus 2. Now by just looking at this equation, we can easily analyze the given parabola. So let's analyze it. It is clear from here that this y will show that axis of symmetry will be y, means focus will lie on the y axis. Now we have to decide on which y, positive or negative, and this will be decided with this sign. This positive sign will show that the parabola will lie on the positive y. This is the analysis that we can do by using the given equation. So two things we have got from here, that it will be on positive y axis, and its axis of symmetry will be the y. Then we move towards the focus. How to find the focus? Focus can easily be found by comparing the given equation with the standard equations. As it is clear that we can compare it, other than x and y, we can compare the constants, that is the A. So let's see with which standard equation we can compare the equation number 1. This is equation number 1, and which will be the equation number 2 from the given standard equations? We have to take this one. This will be the equation number 2, because it corresponds to the given equation other than the x and y. So we'll compare the equation number 1 and 2 as compare 1 and 2. What we will get? 4A equals to 8, so A will be equals to 2. It means the magnitude or the units of focus will be 2 units from the vertex. It shows 2 units from vertex. So focus is not A is equals to 2. We have to find the focus. So 2 units from vertex means we have to add 2 into the vertex. So before going onward, let's draw it for your ease so that you can easily understand further from this point. So let's draw the parabola. As first we have analyzed this, it will be on the positive y axis. Its vertex is 1 and minus 2. Let's see where is 1. So here is 1 and here is minus 2. So this will be the point. 1 and minus 2 will be the vertex. So this point is the vertex. Now focus is here A is equals to 2. It means 2 units from the vertex. So it means we have to move 2 units. As the parabola is in the y-axis, and its face will be upward, so the focus will be on the upward side. So we have to add 2 into the y value, add 2 into y coordinate of vertex to get the focus. So what is the y here? Here y is minus 2, so we will add 2 here. So what we will get is this point will be the focus, where we have 1 and 0. X will remain same and y will change, because we are talking about the focus that is changing on the y axis, that lies on the y axis. If the focus lies on y axis, then its value will then the y value will change, x will remain the same. So here we get the focus. So the value of focus is 1 and 0. Then we move towards the last one, that is the directrix. Directrix all depends on the focus. Now how you will find the directrix of a shifted parabola? The value of y coordinate in the focus is 0. This is the y coordinate, and it all depends, and the directrix is opposite to the is on the opposite side of the vertex on same units as that of focus. As we have added 2 units into the y of vertex, similarly we have to subtract 2 units from the y of the vertex. So I'll write for that subtract 2 units from y of vertex. So what was the y of vertex? Vertex was 1 and minus 2. So minus 2 minus 2 will be minus 4. So I'll write minus 2 minus 2 equals to minus 4. So this will be the point at which we have to draw the directrix. So I'll draw the directrix here as, like, this is the directrix at y equals to minus 4. Y equals to minus 4. This is the equation of the line of the directrix, y equals to minus 4. So we have found the focus, the directrix and the vertex, and it means our parabola will look like something like this. Now I have not found the x and y intercept, as you can find the x and y intercept by putting the x equals to 0 and y is equals to into the given equation of the parabola. So I have just found the focus, vertex and directrix for your ease. That's all from today's lecture. In the next lecture we will find another method to find the focus, vertex and directrix. Thank you
for watching. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel math.com for more updates. Thank you.